everyone, welcome to YouTube channel Physics for Medical and Engineering. Today in this video, we will discuss the types of optical fibers. Let's first briefly see the advantages of fiber optic cable over copper. First, speed. Fiber optic networks operate at high speeds up into the gigabytes. Bandwidth. It has large carrying capacity. Distance. Signals can be transmitted further without needing to be refreshed or strengthened. Resistance. Greater resistance to electromagnetic noise such as radios, motors or other nearby cables. And the last one is maintenance. Fiber optic cables cost much less to maintain. A fiber optic system is similar to the copper wire system that fiber optics is replacing. The difference is that fiber optic use light pulses to transmit information, whereas copper wire system use electronic pulses to transmit information. Now, as mentioned in the earlier video of the optical fibers, the properties of data transmission via a fiber optic depend on the core. Hence, based on the difference in the structure of the core, the optical fiber is classified into three categories, and that is the number of modes, the refractive index, and the material used. A mode is essentially a path that light can follow down the fiber. Now first, on the basis of the number of modes, it is classified into two types, single mode fiber and the multimode fiber. Now the first, single mode fiber. As the name suggests, this type of optical fiber transmit only one mode or one ray of light. To put it another way, it can carry only one wavelength of light across its length. This wavelength is usually 1310 nanometer or 1550 nanometer. Now, you would think that this limits its capabilities of transferring more data, but single mode type of optical fiber is much better than multimode optical fibers as they have more bandwidth and experiences fewer losses. So the speed is unmatched. Interestingly, single mode fibers came into existence after multimode fibers. They are more recent than the multimode cables. This type of fiber has a small core diameter, that is nearly about 5 micrometer, and high cladding diameter, that is 70 micrometer. And the difference between the refractive index of the core and the cladding is very small. There is no dispersion, that is no degradation of the signal during traveling through the fiber. Since it has a very thin core, a strong monochromatic light source, that is a laser source, has to be used to send light signals through it. Now the second one is multimode fiber. As the name implies, this type of optical fibers allow multiple modes of light to travel along their axis. To explain physically, they can do this by having a thicker core diameter. The core diameter is generally 40 micrometer and that of cladding is 70 micrometer. The relative refractive index difference is also greater than single mode fiber. The wavelengths of light waves in a multimode fibers are in the visible spectrum ranging from 850 to 1300 nanometer. The reflection of the waves inside the multimode fiber occurs at a different angles for every mode. As you can see here, the reflection occurs at a different mode. Consequently, based on these angles, the number of reflection can vary. Since the propagation of light based on the principle of total internal reflection, therefore the modes with incident angles that do not cause total internal reflection get absorbed by the cladding. As a result, losses are created and signal degradation occurs due to multimode dispersion. It is not suitable for long distance communication due to large dispersion and attenuation of the signal. There are two categories on the basis of multimode fiber, that is step index fiber and graded index fiber. Basically, there are categories under the types of optical fiber on the basis of refractive index. Now first, step index fiber. This type of fiber has a core of relatively larger diameter such as 50 micrometer It is mostly used for carrying white light, but due to dispersion effect, it is useful for short distance only. The fiber core has a constant refract index N1 such as 1.52 from its center to the boundary with the cladding. The refract index then changes to a lower value N2 such as 1.48, which remains constant throughout the cladding. This is called step index multimode fiber because the refract index steps down from 1.52 to 1.48 at the boundary with the cladding. The next one is multimode graded index optical fiber. Multimode graded index fiber has a core which ranges in diameter from 50 to 1000 micrometer. It has a core of relatively high refractive index, and the refractive index decreases gradually from the middle to the outer surface of the fiber. There is no noticeable boundary between core and cladding. This type of fiber is called a multimode graded index fiber and is useful for long distance applications in which white light is used. The mode of transmission of light through this type of fiber is also the same, that is continuous reflection from the surface of smoothly decreasing refract index and the total internal reflection from the boundary of the outer surfaces. On the basis of material used, it is classified into two types, that is plastic optic fiber and glass fiber. The first one is plastic optical fibers. Plastic optical fiber are made of a polymethyl methacrylate, polystyrene and polycarbonate core and fluoropolymer or silicon resin cladding. Today, perfluorinated polymers are used. They have transmission windows in the visible region, and the transmission losses due to the absorption and scattering of light are very high, and therefore, plastic optical fiber can only be used for short distance data transmission or application up to 100 meter. The next one is glass optical fiber. Glass optical fiber are made of glass cores and glass cladding. The cladding is usually made of very pure silica or fused quartz, while the core is usually silica doped with germanium or phosphorus to increase the refractive index. Well, I hope that helps you get started. To learn even more about fiber optics, watch our earlier video Introduction to Optical Fibers. The link is given in the description box below. If you like the video, hit the like button and subscribe the channel for more such videos. Thank you.